Thank you, Dr. Adin, for this nice presentation and nice illustrations. Shall we move to the next presentation, again by Dr. Monsef Khairallah, evidence of chorio-capillary hypoperfusion on swept source OCTA in specific inflammatory maculopathies. Please, go ahead. Dr.
Thank you, Magdi. I would like to share with you some cases. The purpose of this study is to investigate choroidal involvement on OCT angiography in selected inflammatory diseases using a standard protocol with swept source OCT and angiography. The first case is a typical case of acute Vogt-Koyanagi-Harada disease. Diagnosis can be made based on typical clinical features and OCT and fluorescein angiography findings. And the OCT angiography, as you can see, show choriocapillaris flow reduction mainly in the right eye. And you can see 3 months after treatment, the near completion, complete resolution of choriocapillaris hypoperfusion. The second case is a case of APMPPE. And in this case, you can see multifocal hypointense areas of reduced choriocapillaris flow, mainly in the right eye. And 1 month later, you can see the improved choriocapillaris flow reduction in the right eye. The third case, this is a very atypical case of mutes. In this young patients, a diagnosis of mutes could be made based on typical clinical findings and based on fluorescein angiography, ICG angiography, and OCT. However, OCT angiography, like previous cases of mutes, in this patient, OCT angiography show extensive no-flow areas in the choriocapillaris associated with the projection artifact. And you can see 1 month later a significant resolution of choriocapillaris flow reduction. So maybe in some very atypical case of mutes, we can see choriocapillaris abnormalities in mutes. This is, I think, a very atypical case of mutes, because in mutes, OCT angiography is normally shown normal finding. This is a case of tuberculosis, serpiginous-like choroiditis, and we can see multifocal geographic dark areas of choriocapillaris, flow reduction associated with projection artifact, and 1 month after presentation, the partial resolution of choriocapillaris flow reduction in both eyes. This is a case of relentless placoid chorioretinopathy, and again, the presence of multifocal geographic areas of choriocapillaris hypoperfusion in both eyes, and 3 months, 3 months later, a partial resolution of choroidal hypoperfusion in both eyes. This is a rare disease called unilateral acute idiopathic maculopathy. And as you can see, clinical and fluorescein angiography findings were consistent with a diagnosis of unilateral acute idiopathic maculopathy in these patients. 1 month later, you can see hypofluorescence of the macular lesions associated with extensive choriocapillaris hypoperfusion on fluorescein angiography, alteration of the outer retina and RPE on OCT, and the presence of a large dark area of choriocapillaris hypoperfusion corresponding to the macular lesion seen clinically on FA. This is another important role for OCT angiography is the diagnosis of choroidal neovascularization in association with inflammatory condition. And OCT angiography is very important to detect choroidal neovascularization and in some entity to differentiate between CNV and active lesion. Here a case of CNV associated with serpiginous inactive serpiginous choroiditis, CNV associated with sarcoidosis, you can see the capillary changes in the superficial and deep capillary plexus, as well as the presence of neovascular, choroidal neovascular membrane adjacent to the optic disc. This is a case of bilateral choroidal neovascularization associated with inflammatory choroidopathy, probably a PIC. And OCT angiography is very important in the diagnosis and in following patients and monitoring response to treatment. So in conclusion, swept source OCT angiography may show evidence of choroidal flow reduction in many inflammatory disease, what we call white dot syndromes and other entities. In this condition, the choriocapillaris seems to be the primary site of reversible or persistent ischemic process. Swept source OCT angiography is also useful for the detection and following of inflammatory CNV. And I think that swept source will play an important role in the differential diagnosis, evaluation, and monitoring of various choroidal inflammatory conditions. Thank you for your kind attention.